In The Order of the Phoenix, the fifth of the Harry Potter series, Dolorus Umbridge takes over as the Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher and instantly transforms the classroom into this textbook-based, standardized, test-focused classroom. And Harry questions whether this will prepare them for fighting against Voldemort, he who must not be named. And that's when Umbridge punishes him, and he ends up forming his own school within a school called Dumbledore's Army. Now, Dumbledore's Army is purely inquiry-based. While Harry is the teacher, he is mostly the guide on the side, empowering students to ask questions and find the answers themselves. They rely on each other and on various spell books to solve problems and answer their questions. It is a space of experimentation. And while the process might seem messy compared to Umbridge's standardized approach, the students learn at a rapid pace because they aren't wasting their time repeating what they already know. This is an example of inquiry-based learning, although since it takes place in the UK, it's probably inquiry-based learning. I don't really know. Inquiry-based learning has existed for thousands of years. Both Socrates and Confucius used variations on their own inquiry-based format. It's a critical component to the scientific method of the early Enlightenment, and it was a core idea of both Dewey and Montessori's ideas around student-centered learning. PEDASTE shares a model of the four phases of inquiry. It starts with orientation, which is often a form of discussion. It's where they become aware of the key idea. And from there, it moves into conceptualization, where students generate questions and they define a hypothesis. This leads to an investigation phase, where students explore, experiment, and interpret data, often in a way that's flexible and dynamic. It can even seem kind of cyclical. And then finally, they move into a conclusion. Heather Banchi and Randy Bell define four different types of inquiry that you can view on sort of a spectrum from teacher-centered slash structured into learner-centered slash open. Level one is confirmation inquiry, where the teacher teaches the concepts, creates the questions, and models the process for students. They basically just kind of go along with it to learn about the process. Level two is structured inquiry, where the teacher creates the initial set of questions and kind of shares the procedures, but then the students walk through the rest of the inquiry process by collecting and analyzing the data and drawing their own conclusions. Level three is guided inquiry, and this is sort of the beginning of what we typically think of as inquiry. This is where the teacher provides the initial research question or questions, but students own the research process and the experimentation. And then level four is open inquiry or true inquiry. Here's where students formulate their own questions, design their experiments or their research, and collect their own data or facts that they then share in their findings. Here are a few places where you as a teacher can start with inquiry-based learning. In a language arts or social studies class, you can do a wonder day or one wonder week project where students develop their own questions and move through the inquiry process on their own. You can also do a genius hour project where students not only ask their own questions, but design their own product as well. In math, you could have students explore a concept and develop their own problems, which is one of the things I love about the what can you do with this process of Dan Meyer. And in science, you could do something like a science fair project or a Mythbuster style approach to testing an urban legend. The key idea though is this: if we want students to own their learning, if we want them to remain curious, if we want classrooms to be bastions of curiosity and wonder, well then we need to have something like inquiry-based learning in place so that they learn how to ask great questions, find the answers, and share their results with their peers.